Greetings, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Today we continue on the subject that I've entitled Yesterday, Today, and Forever. And we've looked to the book of Hebrews 13 and verses 8. It says that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And we've looked to the book of Nehemiah, or Nehemiah, depending on how you want to pronounce it. And we've discovered that the book of Ezra and Nehemiah are two books in our Bibles with one author. Interesting enough, I've discovered that the name Ezra literally means Yahweh helps. And the word Nehemiah means Yahweh comforts. Here we have Yahweh helps and Yahweh comforts. Now, Ezra is a biblical typology. It's a type of Christ. When we say that someone is a type of Christ, we are saying that someone in the Old Testament behaved in a way that corresponds with the character or action of Christ in the New Testament. Now, why do we say Ezra is a type of Christ? Ezra brought the word, the Torah, to his people. He was a man of the scripture. If we can read in the book of Ezra, Ezra chapter 7 and verses 10, it reads thus, "For Ezra has prepared his heart to seek the law of the Lord and to do it and to teach statutes and ordinances in Israel." Here we see that Ezra did three things with the scripture. He studied the scripture, he loved the scripture, and he taught the scripture. Ezra's devotion to the scripture led him to have a tender heart towards the people and a heart of compassion, and he wept over the sins of the people. When we look to Christ, he is the final word from God, the final messenger from God. In fact, the Bible says in John 1, he said, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. All things were made by him, and without him nothing was made that was made." If we look to the book of Hebrews chapter 1, the Bible says, "God, who at various times and in various ways has spoken in time past to the fathers by the prophets, has in this last day spoken to us by his own Son, who he has appointed heir of all things, and through whom also he made the worlds, who being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person, and upholding all things by the word of his power, when he himself has purchased our sins, sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high, having become so much better than the angels, for he had by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they." You see, man was always looking for a mediator. And Jesus Christ has become our mediator when he left heaven, came to this earth, died on a cross, and he conquered death, and he conquered the grave, and he went back to heaven, and he seated at the right hand of God as our intercessor, as our mediator, as our advocate in heaven. But he's only the advocate and the mediator of those who put their trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. My question to you today is, do you put your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ? If you haven't yet put your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, I want to challenge you today to put your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. You see, God's goal is not religion. His goal is to have a relationship with you. If we look to the name of Nehemiah, Nehemiah means Yahweh comfort. Nehemiah is a biblical typology of the Holy Spirit. When Jesus walked the earth, he said, "It is to our advantage that he go away. For if he does not go away, then the Comforter will not come." So when Jesus departed, he went to the Father. He sent on the day of Pentecost, he sent the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, to abide with us forever. The Holy Spirit, the Bible says, "For as many as are led by the Holy Spirit, these are the sons of God." The Holy Spirit is the gift that God gave to those who have put their trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. The Greek name for the Holy Spirit is the word parakletos. That means one call alongside to help. We can only receive the gift of the Holy Spirit if we have repented. You see, repentance is a prerequisite to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. The Bible says in the book of Acts 2 and verses 37 to 39, When they heard it, they were pierced to the heart and said to Peter and the apostle, what shall we do? And Peter said to them, repent. Listen to the requirements. He said, repent and be baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of sins. And then you will receive the gift of the Spirit. For the promises is to you and to your children and to all that are far off. So repentance is a three prerequisites. We have asked the question, how do you live in the light of your past, in your today, towards your tomorrow? And we've concluded that many people are prisoners of the past. They are still stuck in their today. They are still stuck in the past in their today. And the only way to get free from that is to repent. We look in the book of Nehemiah. We see that Nehemiah was a man who was repenting before the God of the heavens. He repented because of the sins of the forefathers. And he pleaded God for forgiveness. Repentance is a prerequisite. Repentance is not tears. It's not weeping. You see, we have confused what repentance really means. Repentance is the Greek word metanoia. That means change of direction. Repentance is when we change. And I want to challenge you today. If you haven't yet met the Lord Jesus Christ, if you haven't yet made that commitment, then I want to challenge you to make that commitment, to place your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ. And that's the only way that you can deal with your past, is to repent and to ask the Holy Spirit to come and bring transformation in your life. As we're going to continue tomorrow on the subject, we will see that Nehemiah, it means Yahweh comfort, and we'll see how Nehemiah was strengthened by the Lord to go and rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. I want to conclude with this. In the words of E.M. Bound, he said, the past does not exclude the possibilities, nor deem necessary the great things that the Lord has done in the past. A church that's dependent on its past history for miracle powers and grace is a fallen church. The greatest benefactor that this age can have is a man who can bring its teachers and the church back to prayer. Close quote. The Lord bless you as you meditate upon this truth.